Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem Awakening with me, Get Daved. In the last episode, we stabbed Crom in the chest. He walked it off. So all is right with the world. Okay, the posse down there is a little beaten up, so we'll give Basilio a bit of a buff. I don't know how they're gonna last against three people up there. We're gonna send... Oh man, this is a little tricky. I don't know if we can get anyone else up there. Alright, let's see... Let's see what we can do to improve our situation. We can get one kill. We'll start there. You know, it'd be really nice if Basilio got those hit points. Well, she's snapping necks and cashing checks. Jerkface has already got a silver bow. Okay, he could take 18 damage there and 12 there, which means he could get dropped. And we can't move him out of range. Okay. Does not increase her move. Does not increase her move. Boy, it'd be really nice if I had an extra pair of boots to give her. Okay. The worst thing is, there is a possible way I could find some. Okay, who is... Lucina is by far the most likely person to get a kill. So, I'm gonna park her beside Donnie. I'm gonna pile him on too for the stat boosts. There we go. And now, this guy was going to do the most damage. And she's only B rank, so we can actually still get some practice with the old lance.
Our bonds are strong.
Yeah! Also, we totally chopped that guy in the face. Alright, no retaliation. We have an okay chance of support. So I'm just gonna take the most accurate attack. If we get the support, he dies. It's fine. That group should be relatively safe. Next things next. We pick off the assassino. Is what I would say. So we don't actually care if Morgan hits or not, aside from it would be nice to get experience points. Oh wow. That was just to get a person next to Sayori, so she could get a 100% accuracy attack. Also, one thing, if the enemy units were positioned a little differently, we could have tried to get a kill out of Cordelia or Simia. And then they could have gale-forced to give themselves the range to maybe get another attack in. It didn't happen, but it's a backup. It's a legit backup. And we're actually going to do this instead. So she can use Life Taker. She doesn't need the hit points. She might be at one. There we go. Pretty good level up. There you go. She got the hit points she needed. Next up... Oh, she doesn't actually have a hammer, which is most unfortunate. We'll try for the crit. This is a really good matchup. Wah, wah. And no skills activate. Although I don't think she really had any great ones. Well, Swordbreaker's great, but it's not offensive. Alright, might as well give some experience points. Huh, no kill. Well, we'll hope for a support. We got two chances at it. I love that that's the crit. More weapon skill for all. None of you needed it. Alright. Let's send her into the thick of it and just see what happens. I'm curious. Oh wow, I actually could have used Rally to make my problems go away as well. Give yourself 10 Get Dave points if you realize that in time. Let's forget about Rally movement. Not bad for terrible tomes. Oh, I don't know if you're gonna get the reinforcements in time, buddy. Another option we also could have had, which I did not think of, would be to get Lyssa really close, and she might have been able to reach Basilio with a physics staff. With some dancing, she might have been able to pull it off last turn. Okay, I think we are gonna smash into their lines and rip them to shreds now. Well, we unfortunately can't get him to anyone he can hit with a hammer, but... or, and still have advantage. And that's what Vake would have been, by the way, if he were still in the party. I heard some people talk about how great the warrior class is. It's okay. Okay, let's soften some people up here. If we get a support, which we probably will. It's curtains for him. Well, there went the good luck I'd been having. Alright, I want to find someone who has a sword. Well, I guess I can't show you Swordbreaker right now. Good time, everyone. I enjoy our talks. Perfect. A little bit of damage coming back her way, maybe? If that crit hits, I'll really... yeah. I was kind of playing with fire. She would have been killed. And I know I'm on casual mode, and thus the deaths are not perma. But, I mean, to play a Fire Emblem game properly, like, you can't just be throwing everyone's life away rampantly. Like, you gotta try to conserve units. Now we're talking. And truthfully, the situation can rapidly get out of hand if you aren't respecting people's lives. What is her skill stack? I must know. Oh my goodness. Wow, no, we just got really lucky. Back to... that was really great. Everybody have 84 Get Dave points in celebration. Oh, what a treat. Alright, what are we gonna do next, pardon me. It would be nice if we could gift a kill to Morgan. Well, I guess we just chip away see what we can do with an iron sword. If it crits... Wow. And yet I missed back-to-back supports earlier. From Gaius. Oh well. If Cordelia supports, it's probably a kill. Let's try it. Ooh, not quite. Owing to Cordelia's relatively unremarkable magic stat. We'll do this. Actually, no. Tiki can probably... Yeah, she could take a bite out of this guy anyway. And then perhaps we have Cordelia... Oh, no. We won't even need Cordelia to Gale Force. Dead. And... Oh wow, actually, it's gonna be a little bit of a struggle... Oh, there it is. To get the damage we need. This is not a great unit matchup, but... We didn't even need the kill. Alright, can she take him in one blow? Almost. And then there's a chance she takes 105 damage coming back her way. We're gonna do this and we'll try dropping him this turn. I'm in it to win it, folks. Yeah, there's none to improve the defense stat, so... Hell's Wrath it is. Cross your fingers, everyone. It cannot be unraveled. 1 in 17 chances he dusts us.
What have you?
Didn't even get the word out of his mouth. All wrong! I mean, think about things from his perspective. This is an awful day. Everything was going so well. Turns 4, not bad. Sorry, Dad. Yay! We've won. Well, hold on a minute here. Aversa made it away. And there's the other Get Daved.
Yes.
hold on here. Yeah, so he's Get Daved from this timeline. We are Get Daved from the other timeline, the same world as Lucina. Wait, no, that doesn't make sense then? Okay, no, they're right, I'm wrong.
What?
Well, you should look older then. Well, that is kind of what defines you.
It's not what I believe, but what I do that defines me.
No.
So I guess we were seeing what happened in the other timeline?
Yes.
Hmm. gave him another shot at life. I am lost.
Yes.
Go, watch out, Crom.
What?
Or is he going to use Valadar? I mean, Valadar's dead. I guess he was dead in the other timeline, too. Bad news, everyone. It's a cutscene late in the third act. Favor returned. I guess we shouldn't have killed all those people. Take the Fire Emblem.
It's all over.
She looked a bit like Emerin there. Onward, folks! With me, get daved!
No. Oh, gods, no.
Yep. But Lucina only got a chance to face off against him like she was only a grown woman. After he'd kind of been doing his thing for a while.
Still.
Mm-hmm. It's like right there. Valadar's dead.
Hey.
Yeah. And I thought all the gems were fake. I guess we did bring it there, but...
Ah.
To Mount Prism we go. Do you know where exactly? Makes sense. And now to do 50 paralogues. Or some shopping? No shopping for us. But you know what? We'll loot the barracks. One last fight for the day. Experience points? Yeah. It never did work out having her in the party more. Yay, everyone likes Henry. Yes, you do. Hey, everybody remember Stahl? Yeah, that's fair. I want my job back. Kel was taller than she is. Actually, there is one thing we could look into doing now. And that is, you know, reclassing some of our units. Now, for someone like Crom, he's in a class I want him to stay in. Even though he's reached the skill limit. Kel hasn't quite gotten where I want her to be yet. Sure, I'm kind of happy with her class. Yeah, for someone like Tharia, What are our options? So we could shift her into the sorcerer class. We don't want to put her into a base class. It has to be an advanced one. Yeah, I think I'd do it. I don't see any of these other ones as super desirable for her. So yeah, we'll shift her across. Yeah, we got Life Taker. So a lot of her stats are going to move sideways now because she's switching just from one master class to another. And this is closer to her original character design, so we were probably expected to do this. Dang. All for one magic point. Well, usually it works better than that. It's not random, but I didn't anticipate Dark Knight was boosting her that much. Anyway, now she can start working towards another skill. There's a chance she can hit level 5. Likewise, for Cordelia and Sumia. Now, I probably want them both to move sideways, so Sumia's got the better magic stat. We'll leave her where she is. Maybe we'll do the shift sideways later. Also, I kind of forgot we could masterclass Morgan right now. It's a tempting idea. Shift her over. We could also use a second seal to give her a different base class, which is actually the way I'm gonna go, I think. Oh, what do I know? I'm undecided. It would just be kinda cool if she could get some stat growth as a tactician. No, we don't have time for that. Yeah, we'll go Dark Flyer. Following in her mother's footsteps. Cordelia, I'm a little reluctant to shift right now just because she has almost another level up gained. Yay! Do I look like my father? No. You look like your mother and all that. Likewise, Severa. I don't know if we're going to get a chance to use her, but either a hero or a bow knight. Kind of interesting to have a bow knight in the mix. And we just lost a mounted unit. Yeah, let's go for it. It'll bring us a good variety. And Severa's stat line will lend it her to be a good bow knight. Again, in a perfect world, we would have waited till Cordelia had Gale Force before we would have grabbed Severa, and then she'd have that class, or that skill, pardon me. Movement plus 3. I accept. Just doing our last posturing before the end run. Yeah, Cordelia will wait one more level up because she's so close. And actually, there we go. I'm gonna need some more Master Seals. There we go. Gonna do a little bit more management as we prepare for the end. Just looking to see if there's anywhere I can buy a brave sword. Because that would be quite convenient to have. Especially on someone like Donald. So close, and yet...
What can I fix you with?
Exactly, 65,000 gold, everybody. Yeah, we probably have to do a paralogue. Oh, there is one other thing I've been neglecting. Renown awards. So, just from some of the battles we've been doing, acquired the ability to pick some things up. I think that's mostly for the grinding, though. Alright. We're close, everybody. See you in the next episode.